They came from all over to celebrate number 10.
Lift every voice and sing until heaven ring.
With liberty and justice for all.
Ring with harmony.
Color guard, retreat. Color guard, at ease.
Would you live to be 90 plus?
Give her a round of applause, everyone.
So on behalf of the state of Georgia,
Lord!
A letter from the White House.
Mrs. Naomi King.
I love you so much.
We salute him for having a drink.
He was murdered.
For freedom.
He did not drown.
Just
murder.
Brigade salute King!
To give back.
Equality.
Outside of myself. To show my strength.
Youth Empowerment Award.
Humbling experience.
I'm speechless.
And I'm your host, Natasha Jordan. 10 years has the A.D. King Foundation promoted youth empowerment and nonviolent social change. The festivity recently held at Atlanta State College included dance, songs, awards, and powerful speeches from community activists. And the master of ceremony, Dr. Renee Robinson, did an incredible job of introducing the talented guests. Dr. Robinson.
First up, the Soweto Street Beat Dance, a South African world dance theater company based in Atlanta, Georgia, and Soweto, South Africa. It is the only professional South African dance and music company in the United States. Filling the drums.
I appreciate Dr. Babs inviting me to come in recognition of the 10th anniversary of the A.D. King Foundation and birthday celebration of Mrs. King. I'm State Representative Valencia Stovall of House District 74, and I'd just like to bring greetings on behalf of the state of Georgia and appreciate all you all attending, and definitely appreciate and honor the King family for continuing the legacy. Thank you so very much.
Order my steps in your word.
That was the Universal Peace Foundation, If You Order My Steps. Next up, Jared Ellis, the son of Alveda King, brings us warm greetings from the President of the United States.
I send my warmest greetings to those attending the A.D. King Foundation's 2019 Youth Empowerment Gala in Atlanta, Georgia. Our nation is constantly strengthened by compassionate patriots who are committed to advancing the success of America's future leaders. Organizations like yours are critical to ensuring that the next generation has the opportunity to thrive and better its communities and country. Over the past decade, the A.D. King Foundation's efforts to invest in America's youth through enrichment programs, mentoring opportunities, and initiatives that promote a healthy, nonviolent lifestyle have helped build a brighter and more promising future for our country's children and young adults. Tonight's ceremony is an opportunity to remember the powerful legacy of the servant leader, Reverend A.D. King, and to recognize the individuals whose actions have contributed greatly to the mission and success of the A.D. King Foundation. Reverend A.D. King's movement carries on through the extraordinary work his namesake foundation does in supporting the professional development and personal growth of America's young people. Melania joins me in sending our best wishes for a memorable event and many more years of success. Signed, Donald J. Trump. Thank you.
We now have welcoming remarks from A.D. King's Foundation President and CEO, Dr. Babs Onabanjo, who has worked so diligently over the past 10 years to carry out the organization's mission.
Indeed, it's a great pleasure and honor for me to welcome you to the 10th annual A.D. King Foundation Youth Empowerment Gala and Award. I wish at this outset to extend our warmest thanks and appreciation to all our sponsors for so generously making it possible to host our award gala this evening. Our gala night this night marks the 10th anniversary of A.D. King Foundation and of course the 88th birthday of our Chair Emeritus, Dr. Naomi Ruth Barber King. 88 years. Time goes so fast, doesn't it? And she's still counting. We also like to take this opportunity to celebrate our beloved sister and freedom fighter, Yolanda King, who was the daughter of the Civil Rights Movement, who was born on the same date and shares birthday with Dr. Naomi King. I would like to remind you about the King's family's sacrifices, and I'd like to recount them. The assassination of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. in Memphis, the assassination of Mama King on a Sunday morning in the church while playing Our Father's Prayer, the bombing of Reverend A.D. King's home or parsonage in Birmingham, Alabama, the bombing of his office church in Louisville, Kentucky, and finally his suspicious drowning without water in his lungs in his own swimming pool, in which he was very familiar with, rings around his neck and bruises on his forehead in 1969. So this marks the 50th anniversary of his memory, 50 years ago. But we shall stand for a moment for silence to remember all those good fighters who have fallen along the sides and have joined the heavens. May the souls of the departed full soldiers and the freedom fighters rest in perfect peace. Let us finally close with Dr. King's quote, "Peace is not the absence of tension, it is the presence of justice. We must develop and maintain the capacity to forgive. He who is devoid of the power to forgive is devoid of the power to love. God is able, God is love. Love your neighbor as yourself, as God has commanded us."
The Nation of Islam drill team is honoring our brother, Dr. A.D. King, by stepping to freedom and social change.
We honor our brother, Dr. King.
We salute him for having a dream. For freedom, justice, equality, we now must have. For a kind is calling for 10,000 strong. Got the soldiers struck upon the call.
One God!
Where's the devil? Cause we got him on the run. Piss out the mission till the work is done.
A lot, he waits for a soul.
Attention, attention, left face.
And so when I think about the legacy of A.D. King and Miss Naomi Ruth Barbara King, Miss Butterfly, she encompasses all of those things. The passage, one of it says, is she is clothed in strength and dignity. She can laugh at the day to come. She speaks with wisdom and faith instruction with her tongue. I can add to that she's a wonderful spirit just by being her presence in the room. And what I want everyone to do now is stand to your feet as we bring to the stage Dr. Naomi Ruth Barbara King.
Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Why for a minute more?
Love you. Miss Barbara King.
This evening, as we honor our award recipients who have made a difference in our communities, state, nation, and our world, we must also honor the commitment of A.D. King Foundation in empowering youth through enrichment programs and activities over the past 10 years. Thank you, Dr. Babs. Programs and activities include 1, mentoring, 2, promoting nonviolent strategies as a way of life, 3, entrepreneurship program, 4, annual civil rights legacy tour, Birmingham, Montgomery, and Selma, 5, elementary, middle, high stay in school seminar programs, 6, back to school program, 7, partnership with law enforcement and community policies, 8, legislative and influencers and promoting healthy lifestyles. I want to congratulate all the recipients who are blazing the trail each day, transforming lives within their communities and beyond. Again, I say congratulations. We are honoring my late great husband, who was my Boaz, the love of my life. The Reverend A. D. Williams King, brother to the dreamer, who himself dreamed of a society of nonviolence and peace. And he bravely lived and died for that cause 50 years ago. Make no mistake about his death. It was not accidental drowning. He was murdered by his activism in the civil rights movement. I hope you all heard what I said. His parsonage home was bombed in Birmingham, Alabama. His church office was bombed in Louisville, Kentucky, and there was no water in its lung. So tell me, how do you drown when you're an excellent swimmer and there's no water in your lungs and you're in a fetal position? Please, he did not drown. He was murdered. As A.D. King Foundation continues my beloved husband's legacy for civil and human rights, we must strive to pass on this legacy to the youth in order to empower them to continue in the quest for positive social change and nonviolent strategies as a way of life. So the bottom line is, let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with each of us. I love you so much. Thank you. God bless you.
Heather on violin and Christian on flute, together performing Peace Begins With Me. You're in for a treat.
Thank you all for being here tonight. It's so important to support the A.D. King Foundation because of all the good work that it's done and is able to do that work because of the support that you all give us. Alfred Daniel Williams King. He was named after his grandfather and my great-grandfather because he too was a force in his own right. Atlanta owes their first high school here in Atlanta, the Booker T. Washington High School, to Alfred Daniel Williams, who led the fight and made Atlanta, the school board, the Board of Education, build a high school for black students because the one did not exist. So they had to be called by the initials so that they could establish and have their own identities here in this community. I'm proud of the fact that they were raised in a family, in a lineage that continues through us, that raised them and us to give back to the community that has nourished our growth and development. I'm proud to be not only the nephew of Martin Luther King Jr., but the nephew of Alfred Daniel Williams King, who, as you've heard, has contributed in his own right. And that's why I'm appreciative of the fact that Aunt Naomi took it upon herself to reach out to a Dr. Babs and say, let's concentrate on the youth. Let's concentrate on the youth that are coming along, because those are the ones that are picking up the torch, and those are the ones that will make the future for us. Those are the ones that will carry the dream forward. But those are the ones that are sometimes and most often overlooked. So it's important for the youth to know not only was Martin Luther King Jr. a very human person, but he had a very human brother who, for them, was sometimes cowed by the legacy of a Martin Luther King Jr., can look to his brother and see that they too can make their own way and their own contribution in their own way. So thank you again for supporting the great work that this foundation has done. It could not be done without you. Thank you, Aunt Naomi, for the aunt that you've been to me, for sharing Uncle AD with me, and now for sharing him with the world.
And as the King family shares Dr. Alfred Daniel William King with the world, we present a short video commemorating his life and accomplishments.
The Reverend A.D. Williams King was born in 1930 to Dr. and Mrs. Martin Luther King Sr.
All of a sudden, I looked at my picture window and I noticed it had begun to crack. I didn't hear anything, I didn't see anything, but I noticed my picture window begin to crack. And simultaneously, my husband came up from the bedroom, and by the time we got to the middle of our home, the second bomb hit.
World War II veteran named Roosevelt Tatum, who introduced himself, said he lived in the neighborhood and asked if he could come in. He would like to talk with them.
Martin Luther King Jr. believed in nonviolence. He did love his neighbor as himself.
I'm proud of the fact that we have people like A.D. and others in the movement who gave their lives and their capacity for thought and perspective and vision to the movement.
And I think that it would be good for America and the world to see what he was able to accomplish with the help of God in his own right.
Like his brother and other members of his family, was deeply committed to end segregation.
He was more radical than what you would think.
AD was just as important as ML.
That danger and death were lurking in the shadows.
He was under constant threat. People were continuing to say, we got your brother, we're gonna get you.
So I have left yet something that you can't take away, still left with me, faith, hope, love.
I know what I heard, and I ain't gonna dispute nobody, I ain't gonna debate nobody. The emergency worker said, ain't no water in his lungs. He was dead before he hit the water. And I said, what?
Most disturbing thing to me, how a drowned man didn't have no water in his lungs.
Many people at the time that my father, Reverend A.D. King, died, expressed doubts that it was accidental. The very first reports, they tried to say that Dad had committed suicide.
There was a swimming pool in the backyard. And of course, at that particular time, I was a little afraid of water. I was only 6 years of age, and Uncle A.D. was a very good swimmer.
It's good for us as a family to kind of reflect back on this. We've lived with this and we've known it, but it's good to kind of pull it off the shelf.
They were determined and committed to a cause, and they were willing to pay the ultimate price.
He was at every mass meeting. His church was one of the churches that ended up as a headquarters, not only for voter registration and for demonstrations, but for training young people. So he was right in the middle of all of the movement activity, and one of the real leaders.
There would be no possible, as we're filming this, black president, had there not been an A.D. King, had there not been these men and women who were willing to lay their lives on the line.
Nothing is more powerful than an idea whose time has come. And nothing is more frustrating than to try to push forth an idea whose time has not come. So we've talked about running for political office. Here we are in 2008 talking about electing a black president. I mean, showing up.
All I can say to you all that don't know A.D., what a man, what a man, what a mighty man.
There is no doubt in my mind that the system killed my beloved husband, the Reverend A.D. Williams King.
Myself daydreaming, imagining life outside of myself. Do I love me enough, or am I just a broken vessel? I have faced challenges that have wounded my soul. Trials have made my heart so cold. I've had tribulations that have threatened to tear me down. See, I am surrounded, and yet I am alone. I speak, and no one listens. My heart is frozen, oozing bloody tears, tears of a young man growing in a cold world, tears of a young woman growing in a shameless void. Bullies and trolls are all around me. They keep my eyes open during the day, and they keep my mind open at night. I put on my dress and heels and my bracelet, not knowing if I'm going to be loved or if I'm going to be abused. I put on my jeans, my sneakers, and my chain, not knowing if I will get back home. I have been to the suburbs, I have been to the ghetto. Each one of them has his own pain. In the morning, when I look in the mirror, I try to shout a prophetic shout of victory, but instead, I whisper like a wounded animal. In my defeat, I'm forced to look deep into my frozen heart. Failure stands next to my feet, and yet a voice whispers, a voice from the heavens, a voice not so cruel. This is your winter. Be still and believe. Unto my soul, my mind, and my spirit, a light illuminates, casting a ray of sunshine on my broken pieces.
Eartha Sims has been singing professionally since the age of 5. She has performed with Al Green, Isaac Hayes, the Spelman College Glee Club, and Kool and the Gang. Now she's taking a page from the life of Naomi King.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. That was my favorite song. My mama taught it to me. She said that that would be my purpose in life, to shine a light in the path for black people and others who begin a hard walk. Then she taught me a prayer of protection. And the prayer of protection was, I put on the whole armor of God, and I stand to know the Holy Spirit. Amen. Something always tests me after that prayer. One day, I didn't know that I'd be saying that prayer one day with a battle-scarred king, Alfred Daniel Williams King. So when AD and I started dating in 1946, I wanted him to take me to the Fox Theater to see a film called Blue Skies with Bing Crosby and Fred Astaire in it. And he said, no, because Daddy King didn't allow his children to patronize segregated businesses. So, to show my strength and independence, I went by myself. Now, to get in the Fox Theater, if you were black, you couldn't go in the front door and you couldn't go in the back door. You had to climb all the way up the side of the Fox Theater on these stairs and go in through the balcony if you were black. Well, by the time I got there, it was pouring down rain. And I was so soaking wet. But I went in and I watched that movie by myself. When I got home, all wet and cold. Now I love AD. But he said, see, you shouldn't have gone anywhere. So I dropped my head and I looked all defeated. And then he wrapped me in his arms and he said, but I love you. So I'm on. We were pretty soon married, really soon after that. Because God made it right, I'll cherish thee through light and love all the time. A wider world of hope I see, because you come to me. Lord, give me the strength to do your will and obey your holy commandments and to know your insights through the Holy Spirit and to know the needs of my husband and my family and
We put on the whole armor of God, the blessed plate of righteousness.
There's a song by Nina Simone that comes to mind as we bring up our youth honorees. It goes, to be young, gifted and black. Oh, what a lovely, precious thing. Yes, the world is waiting for you. Open your heart to what it brings.
Hi, I'm Mateo Hunter. I'm currently a freshman at Shambly Charter High School. I participate in the marching band and enjoy math and science. I hope to pursue a career in the STEM field one day. I would also like to thank the A.D. King Foundation for honoring me with the Youth Empowerment Award. I'm truly honored to be recognized by such an esteemed organization. I would also like to thank the foundation for giving me the opportunity to attend the Civil Rights Tour in Alabama. During the trip, I was able to see and hear firsthand accounts of life in America during the Civil Rights Movement. It was one thing to read about history in textbooks or taught at school, and another to witness what many who came before us experienced. Of the many sites we toured during the trip, I'd have to say what became the most memorable moment for me was visiting the Lynching Museum. To see the people's names hanging above my head was a feeling I'd never forget. It made me realize these were people's family members, our ancestors. This was American history hanging before me. Another experience I appreciated was visiting the Rosa Parks Museum. There were details assessed that had been left out of history books, and I was surprised to learn that there was so much to her story and the moment she refused to give up her seat. I was also impressed with the level of organization it took to ensure the bus boycott was a success. With limited resources, no cell phones, and social media, the youth, as well as the older generation, were able to work together to make a difference. A major lesson I learned is that it doesn't matter how young you are, you're never too young to make an impact. This is one of the many reasons I enjoy being a Boy Scout as well. Scouting has taught me how to thrive in situations with limited resources, and also how to be a better leader.
Hi, I'm Victoria Shivers. I'm 25 years old, and I'm a native of Atlanta, Georgia. I'm a proud alumna of Columbus State University, where I earned my Bachelor of Science in Mathematics. Currently, I'm a math educator at Cedar Grove High School, where I teach coordinate algebra, advanced algebra, and pre-calculus. I also serve as the assistant varsity coach for the cheerleading team, and I mentor and tutor students within the community. In addition, I serve in various leadership capacities within different organizations, such as the American Business Women's Association, We Impact Incorporated, and the Retreat ATL. I'm extremely passionate about seeing young African American students become interested in STEAM-related fields, science, technology, engineering, and math. I want to leave you with this quote that math is the key and door to the sciences, Galileo Galilei. I'm extremely honored to be a recipient of this prestigious reward from the A.D. King Foundation. Thank
you. I'm a singer, songwriter, and I'm gonna say that it's been the greatest honor of my life to be able to share my talent and my gift with the world. I started music at a very, very tender age, and I remember, you know, always learning how to sing African folklore with my grandma in the village. It was the most beautiful moment of my life, where I would sit under the, you know, moonlight and tell us this folklore and just listen, enjoy, and then, you know. And then, well, when I got to high school, you know, we had this press club. Everybody went to the press club just to talk about stuff happening every day. And I just got bored, and then I started my own group. It was a musical group called Echoes of Praise. And Echoes of Praise, I got, you know, some of the girls that were in Echoes of Praise were so interested, and I formed my own group, the Just Sisters, with three beautiful ladies that would sing our heart out. And we started, you know, walking, and before I knew, it became a career. And from there, we took it out from school, started to sing at different churches, events. And the first time I went to the studio was I think I was 14. We went to sing my school anthem. You know, we had like an inter-house sport. That meant the world to me. Like, wow, I love this experience. And I told myself, this is where I belong, right here in the studio and on the stage. And from there, I've never ever looked back, choosing, you know, to walk in this path. And fast forward to 2013, before, you know, when I came to the U.S. and nothing changed. Instead, it got even better. And I told myself, you know, I'm gonna use my voice, you know, to support and be the voice for the voiceless.
This year, honorees, as they come, I want you to stand and give them a round of applause. Mr. Hunter, please come forward, our honoree. Give him a round of applause. Mrs. Shivers and Ms. Onabanjo. Please come forward. Again, give them a round of applause. These are our future leaders.
Truly an honor to be honored and to receive this Youth Empowerment Award. I hope to, as I move along in Boy Scouts, continue to empower the youth. Thank you.
This is a very humbling experience to receive this award from such a prestigious organization and foundation. I've worked with Dr. Onabanjo. He was actually my computer science professor when I went to Atlanta Metropolitan to receive my associate's degree. So I honor him. Where is he? Oh, I honor you so much, and I just thank you for pouring into me so that I can pour into the youth. And guys, youth are so important. They're part of the next generation. So whenever you can, just do what you can and do your part to give back. Thank you.
I'm speechless. I'm so honored and so humbled to be here tonight. I already don't know what to say. I just want to say thank God, and I love you, love you, love you so much. Sis Naomi, Barbara King, thank you so, so very much. You've been a blessing to this world, a blessing to women, young girls. You remind us that we can dream, and you know, and I'm a dreamer, and I'm still dreaming. And that dream keeps coming through every day, each passing day. Dr. Onabanjo, thank you so very, very much for this great opportunity. I met you some years back and you never let me go. You just believe so much in me. And I want to say thank you. And for everybody in this room tonight, you all are family. I flew in from Pittsburgh just this afternoon, and it's always an honor to be here. I consider myself a part of the AD King family, and I think family is not only by blood, it's by everything, by love. And I choose this family by love, and thank you for welcoming me again. I love you all.
Thank you. Next we have our international honoree, Senator Adeleke. Give him a round of applause.
Good evening. I'm accepting this award from my father. Couldn't make it today. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Dr. Christine King Ferris. I was here. I lived. I loved. I was here. I did, I done everything that I wanted, and it was more than I thought it could be. I will leave my mark so everyone will know I was here. Stand and give her a round of applause for all the things that she's done. She is the sister of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Whereas
November 16th, 2019, the A.D. King Foundation will recognize immense contributions of Dr. Willie Christine King Ferris by granting her the highest award entitled Living Legend Award, Lifetime Achievement, and Matriarch of the King Family. And whereas Dr. Willie Christine King Ferris taught at Spelman College and held a tenured professorship for 48 years before retiring in 2014. Whereas Dr. Willie Christine King Ferris was for many years vice chair and treasurer for the King Center and had been active for several years in the International Reading Association and various churches and civic organizations, including the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People and the Southern Christian Leadership Conference. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the House of Representatives that the members of this body recognize and commend the Dr. Willie Christine King Ferris for her dedication to the legacy of the civil rights movement and her service to the community and the world. And the proclamations keep rolling in. This one is from the Atlanta City Council recognizing the A.D. King Foundation. The Atlanta City Council is pleased to recognize the A.D. King Foundation for its 10th annual Youth Empowerment Gala and for its unrelenting quest to eliminate poverty, war, violence, and racism. The foundation has remained true to its mission of promoting youth empowerment and nonviolent change strategies as a lifestyle, with the goal of achieving a beloved community, with social justice and entrepreneurship as its core. Its impact on youth leads us to the day in which the community is free of past scourges of poverty, war, violence, and racism. Now, therefore, be it resolved that we, the members of the Atlanta City Council, on behalf of the citizens of Atlanta, do hereby recognize the A.D. King Foundation on the 16th day of November 2019 for its 10th annual Youth Empowerment Gala and its continued effort to make the beloved community more than a dream.
We hope you enjoyed the 10th annual A.D. King Foundation's Youth Empowerment Gala. And as always, we leave you with remarks from the President and CEO, Dr. Babs Onabanjo. We cannot change the world without changing the narrative that defines the power which sustains the problem. And I'm Natasha Jordan.
In case you don't understand when you see me stand and clap my hands,
it's just my way to give thanks and praises to God.
Strange.
When I call out my Jesus name,
it's just another way to give praises to Him.
When you see me lifting my hands up to thee,
at times you may hear me saying over and over and over again
how much I really love the Lord.
I'm grateful to Him.
Fought and my victory's won.
so great.